Hello and welcome to a new video from Build with Rafiq. Today, I'm going to show you how to build an indoor air quality monitor using the PIC-BLE and Air Quality 7 click. Before I start with the tutorial, let me show you what the project will look like. The Air Quality 7 click is attached to the PIC-BLE development board via the microbus header. The PIC-BLE is connected through Bluetooth low energy to a mobile device where all received values are displayed. Let's start with showing all the components I will use in this video. The Microchip PIC-BLE development board is designed to quickly and easily enable BLE for any extreme low power wireless applications. The PIC-BLE is based on the PIC-16LF18456 microcontroller, features the ATECC608A crypto authentication secure element and the RN4870 Bluetooth low energy module. The PIC-BLE includes a microbus socket enabling the addition of various sensors and actuators options offered by Microelectronica. The board can be powered via micro-USB or a CR2032 battery. The sensor we will be using to monitor the indoor air quality is MikroE's Air Quality 7 click. It is a VOC and CO2 sensor module that uses state-of-the-art metal oxide sensor technology with intelligent detection algorithms. On board is the Amphenol MICS VZ89TE integrated sensor module, ideal for indoor air quality monitoring. The Air Quality 7 click communicates to the host MCU via the I2C interface. Let's start by hooking up the hardware parts together. Assembling the hardware parts is straightforward. Because of the microbus socket, soldering or wiring is not needed. All you have to do is attach the Air Quality 7 click board to the PIC-BLE development board. Ensure you connect it correctly by aligning the 3V3 pin of the click board with the PIC-BLE board's 3V3 pin. Download and install MPLAB X IDE and XC8 compiler. Connect the PIC-BLE with a micro USB cable to the PC. In MPLAB, click on Tools, Plugins, Available Plugins, and install MPLAB Code Configurator MCC. This is not visible on my screen because I already have it installed. MPLAB will then ask you to restart the IDE. After restarting MPLAB, click on File, then New Project. In the pop-up window, select Microchip Embedded Standalone Project, then click Next. Select the device by typing in the Devices tab, PIC-16LF18456. Then select the PIC-BLE SN MCHP under Tool. If you can't see this under Tool, make sure the PIC-BLE is connected to the PC. Click and open MCC. On the left side panel under the Device Resources tab, I'm going to select USR2, which will enable the BLE functions. Under Foundation Services, select I2C Simple. This will add the I2C drivers to our application, which we will use later to read the Air Quality 7 click sensor data. The next step is to configure our pins in the MCC pin manager. For this, you'll need to check the pinout diagram of the PIC-BLE. For the BLE connection, you'll need to lock the following pins: RC4 for the USR2 TX and RC5 for USR2 RX. For the I2C connection, you'll need to lock the following pins: RB1 for I2C SCL and RB2 for I2C SDA. In the end, you should have the same configuration as mine here. Finally, click on Generate. In this part of the project, I'll go through the main parts on how to read the sensor data from the Air Quality 7 click. In the project directory under the header files, you'll need to create a header file where the function that will read the sensor data is declared. Next, we'll create a C file under the source files group, which will contain the code for reading the raw sensor data and converting these readings into understandable numbers. Let's go through the main points of the code. The first thing is to include the header file we created and include the I2C drivers generated by MCC. Next is to define the MICS VZ89TE sensor I2C address and the register address, which will return an array with the sensor readings. The address and register can be found in the device datasheet. Inside the MICS VZ89TE read sensor data function, we will call the I2C read data block function. The first argument is the sensor address. The second argument is the register for retrieving the sensor data. The third argument is the array where we'll save the sensor's raw values. And the fourth argument is the size of the array. The last step is to check if we have data available from the sensor. If true, we convert the raw values received using the equations provided in the sensor datasheet. The last file you'll need to edit is the main.c file, which can be found under the source files group. You'll need to include the MICS VZ89TE sensor header and the STDIO library, as we'll be working with strings. Inside the while loop, we'll call the MICS VZ89TE read sensor data function, and finally print the output to the BLE terminal on the mobile device, which I'll show you how in the next step. With the PIC-BLE connected to the PC, click on the Make and Program in the top panel in MPLAB X. In the following step, I'll show you how to connect the PIC-BLE to a mobile device. To receive the data via BLE, you'll need to download a BLE terminal app on your mobile device. I'm using an Android device in this tutorial. Download an app called Serial Bluetooth Terminal from the Google Play Store. After downloading the app, open it and navigate to the Bluetooth LE tab. In the top panel, hit Scan to start searching for the PIC-BLE device. Once the scan is done, click on the PIC-BLE device. The blue LED on the PIC-BLE should turn on once the connection is established. You should start seeing data coming from the PIC-BLE sent over Bluetooth Low Energy to your mobile device. This tutorial provided a detailed overview of how to read sensor data via I2C and send the data via Bluetooth Low Energy to a mobile device. Microchip PIC-BLE enables a quick and easy way of adding BLE connectivity to your application. Thanks to the onboard microbus header, a MikroE air quality sensor is added quickly to this application. Another feature of the PIC-BLE is that it has a CR2032 battery holder, making it ideal for a wireless sensor node. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to drop a like on the video, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and click the bell to be notified when we post new ones. Also, if you want to read about more projects like this, visit mouser.com/applications/open-source-hardware and click the project tab.